Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I'm currently sick, so you'll have to excuse any stuffiness or sniffling. Alright, so we were exploring this watery place down here. Let's keep going. So I came from over there, I've gotten everything from there. There's an item over here, let's go grab it. Oh look, it's just in the middle. Nothing nasty around as far as we can see. I bet a dragon's gonna come down and pluck me off the earth and drop me into a volcano. Huh, no dragon. Suspicious dead end. Highly suspicious. Pointless dead end. Unless, wait a minute. Wait. Nope, not a false wall. Okay. Do you think the level designers put weird dead ends like that in the game, thinking, and somebody's gonna go in there and they're gonna expect something and they're gonna find nothing and I'm gonna waste their time? Are they that evil? Ambush, yeah, that's no surprise. That's a carcass. That one and that one. Those two seem to be moving. Oh yeah, that's alive. Fucking hell! Ooh. I'm not sure what's more terrifying, those things or those slug creatures. Can I backstab it? I don't think it has a back. I seem to remember... I shouldn't desecrate their corpse like that. Sorry for walking on your body. I seem to remember somebody looking just like that who was friendly. And there was a message right next to them that said, use item or something like that. Is that what I just got? Wasn't that just a spell, though? A heal spell or something? Yeah, great heal. Restore high HP for self and vicinity. Okay. Do I need to heal that person? Can I? If I don't use magic, can I even use it? I have no idea how magic actually works. I don't know. Maybe it works like weapons, where if you don't have the, like, if you don't have the strength for it, you can two-hand it. And you can, like, be better with using it. So maybe spells, you have to, like, two-hand it with your left and right brain. Yeah, that makes sense. It's a dead end, or if it goes deeper. I want to go here first. How did all these people die? So they were attacked by something. But what? Bonfire ahead, ooh! Ally? Bonfire ahead. Yes, bonfire! Ah. It's such a soothing thing to find a bonfire. It feels just like safety. Whoops. I meant to bring out the torch. It's a dark... What? What? The hell does that mean? It's a dark? Oh, just that it's dark? Okay. Lonely. Secret ahead. Hmm. Alright, hold on. I want to scout this out a little bit first. So I can go down there. I can also go around underneath this place over there. But what's across the bridge? Gorgeous view. Praise the view. It is pretty. Guess there's truly nothing over here, other than poorly textured rocks. Okay, before I go underneath the castle, I think I want to see what this so-called secret is. That is an odd patch of darkness. It seems unnaturally dark, almost like there's something hiding inside of the dark. Be wary of left. Why are they running away? Are they getting some friends? Oh, one of those. Hello. Fire person coming up the stairs? Yes. Okay. Should we go down here or just underneath the castle? I feel like underneath the castle probably doesn't go much deeper. If this goes deeper into like a whole new instance, then I feel like this up here probably doesn't. So let's go check out this first. At least they're easy to stun. Dung pie, oh my god. Don't tell me that's a throw. Oh my god, it is a throwable, isn't it? Turns enemy toxic, but also affects user. Dried fecal waste material. Moist on the inside. Throw out enemy to inflict toxin buildup, but also ups your own toxicity. Though the stench makes it difficult to carry on one's person, inflicting toxins on an enemy yields high damage over time. Perhaps some undead have fond memories of waste. Or perhaps not. What, the undead have fond memories of waste, so they decided to bake up some dung pie. That is a fascinating bit of Dark Souls lore? Invading another world? What? Why? I thought that only happened in the forest. Okay. Let's try to battle somebody. Oh, takes me back to the forest. Also, what is happening? Jesus Christ. I'm scared. I don't know what's happening. I'm just gonna go away from the weird... the weird... thing. Hey! Oh my god, do I have to fight all of them? Or, oh, I just have to fight you. Oh, no, I have to fight you too, okay. Okay, that crab's real. It's corporeal. Confirmed. You know, I do have the seed. Oh, that doesn't work in this case. Okay. It only works when other people invade me, I think. Oh, I'm so dead. Okay, just kill me. I'm just gonna let them kill me. I have no chance against a laggy opponent and three opponents at the same time as well. Like, no way. Not gonna happen. As much as I like being a watchdog of Farron, I don't really want to invade other people's worlds because that online experience just blows. All three are gonna wake up at the same time? Oh, no. Sadness ahead. All of them. Ooh. Excrement covered ashes. Ew! What do I do with that? What's with all this shit? And also, where is it? Oh, right, I still have an undead bone shard. Shrine Handmaiden prepares new items, perhaps. Okay. Here's some shit-covered ashes. Please make me something new. I'm sure she'll be elated. Oh. So this actually does really lead somewhere, doesn't it? I had to. Estus stew? Yeah. I forgot what that does. Is it a one-time heal, or... I think it's a one-time heal. Raise the soup. This place is gorgeous. Huh. Looks like they're looking at the painting. Be a throne? Be wary of fire. It is. Whoa! Ow, ow, ow. Oh shit. Whoa. Gotcha. Divine Blessing. Fully restores HP and cures ailments. Ooh. Asshole. Come on down here. Another one. Oh. Diseased bots. Or, oh, 3 chests. I'm sure at least one of those is fake. All right, this one's good. This one's good. Smough's Great Hammer. Ornstein and Smough from Dark Souls 1. I'm sure that's going to require a lot of strength. Oh my god, 45, yeah. Does a shit ton of damage. Twisted Great Hammer associated with Smough, the last knight to remain at his post, guarding the ruined cathedral. Restores HP while attacking, a carryover from Smough's past as an executioner. Yep. That's Smough's hammer. Well, actually, that's like a 1/5 scale replica of Smough's hammer. That's me attempting to roll while carrying the hammer. It's like, oh, I can't do it. This thing's comically huge. It just clips through the ground and everything. Ugh. Yeah, so this is the quick attack. That's in air quotes because it's not actually quick. This is the strong attack. And special attack. Oh, right, I should probably two-hand it. Special attack. Really? They're all real. Well, that's a surprise. Ooh, new ring. No mimicry ahead. That's actually true. Strengthens thrust weapon counterattacks. Ring associated with Dragon Slayer Ornstein, one of the four knights of Gwyn, the First Lord. Strengthens thrust weapon counterattacks. Ornstein was the first knight of the Sun's eldest born, and his cross spear is said to have pierced scales made of stone. Is my weapon a thrusting weapon? That's the important question. It is, actually. Spear, thrust. How often do I actually do counterattacks? So just in case you don't know, I believe what a counterattack is if you attack an enemy while it is in the process of carrying out its own attack, I believe that's considered a counterattack, and it gives you bonus damage to them. So it's like you're interrupting their attack, and that gives you bonus damage. Like they're not, they're not protecting themselves as well. They're leaving themselves open while they're attacking. I don't know how often I do that. I never actually deliberately go for counterattacks, so if I get any benefit from it, it would have to be just by luck. I just, dodge and attack when I can. I don't know. I think I like my rings. No, you know what? Let's change it up. This I'm definitely going to keep. I love the invisible rolling. Absolutely need stamina recovery speed. This is awesome, but this maximum HP thing, I'm sure I could be fine without it for a bit. Let's try the Leo ring. See if I notice any big difference. Oh my god, they're all cold. Did they just take cold damage from smashing that face? Dragon Slayer Greatbow. Greatbow used by the Dragon Slayers during the Age of Gods. Far greater in size than any normal bow and far more devastating. The bow must be anchored to the ground when fired, a time-consuming operation that leaves the user vulnerable. Only specialized great arrows can be fired from the bow. Makes sense. Thing's ridiculously huge. See if I can get a backstab in here. Haha! Alright, that's all cleared out. Let's go back down below. I'm guessing this is going to link up with somewhere where I've already been. Visions of Ring. Don't know if it's talking about the Leo Ring or something else. Hello, doggies. Oh, it's just one of those little angry invisible spirits. Oh god. Chaos! Okay. I can't figure out a good tactic for fighting packs of dogs. Honestly, I kind of just dodge a couple times and then just sort of mash attack until I kill one of them. It's so chaotic. Alright. Oh, you know what? Before I go back there and try to get my souls back, let's actually go use my undead bone shard. And also, I guess, give the feces-covered ash to the, whatever her name was. Shrine Maiden? Here's the excrement covered ashes.
Gracious. Passing fine ash thou hast given.
Oh, she liked it.
Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new wares content thee.
Question now is, will I remember what's new? New rings? I don't know. Probably new sets of armor. I'll look at that later. I've actually got to go quite a ways to get back to where I died, and I think I dropped like 20,000 souls. Uh-oh. Given how far I traveled, I was probably pretty close to a bonfire. Let's see if they'll follow me up here. Can they come out of the water? Yes. Oh, it's gone for good. Is the bowman also gone? Yeah, cool. I wonder who that is. Is that, oh, wait a minute. That is... I think that's the woman from, Dark Souls 1. The gigantic, ridiculously massive woman. I don't remember what her name was, but that looks like her. I guess I wasn't actually that far away. 29,000 souls, yeah, I'm glad I got that back. Alright, rematch, doggies. Jesus Christ! They're so freaking hard! Also, with my Estus Flask plus 5 plus the ring that increases my Estus regeneration, I can almost do a full heal with one Estus. It's pretty sweet. Okay, I'm good now. I can handle one. Gonna Estus just to be conservative. Don't think I'm gonna run out of Estus. Alright. Oh, hello. Shortcut. Ooh. Not sure where that goes up to, but let's unlock the shortcut first. I think I've been here before. Yes? Yes, I have. Yeah, okay. be honest, though, I don't actually know what... Ooh, is there a secret here? Nope, just a weird wall. I don't actually know what bonfire is closest to that shortcut up there, though. I don't remember. I think that's near the beginning of this whole zone, I think. I'm not sure. Yeah, there's a lot of pathways that I can go now, and I'm not exactly able to keep all of them in my mind. I'm not exactly sure where all of them are. So I can fall down there and get that item. Ooh, that one was a surprise. That might go down to the item. Yeah, let's go check it out. Yep, it does. I have a whole heck of a lot of souls. In fact, I have so many that I think now is actually a pretty good time. I'm just going to temporarily switch out the Leo ring, which I still haven't made up my mind about, with a ring of sacrifice. So that means I won't lose my souls if I die. Just in case. Enemies up there. Now where's that down there? That's where I just go. Oh, hello. A scythe! I don't know what you're doing, but I don't like it. Thank God their attack missed. Ooh. Oh God. Your type. One with the 5 attack combos or 6 attack combos or infinite combos, whatever it is. Please let me out. Please let me out of the corner. Please let me out of the fucking corner, I can't move! Oh God. So yeah, there's an item over there, but I probably need to fall off of the place up there to get down to it. I don't think I can walk over. No. You did it. How'd you jump on that? Good for you. Ooh, boss. I'm not ready yet. Visions of old codger. By the way, it'll happen to you too. Yes, it will. Oh, here we go. This links up with that place down there. Down there is where that shortcut was. Okay, this is starting to link up now. Enemy giant ahead. Yeah, I'm not touching that yet. Not until I've secured the VLZ. To use those hot terms that young people use nowadays. Alright, well, I feel comfortable going down here now. I'm guessing that gate only opened from one side. Are you coming? So yeah, I know there's a pyromancer, yeah, right down there. I remember I was actually walking directly above it at one point before I turned around. Illusion ahead. Hmm? Really? I'm gonna believe in your message. Well, fuck me. Not sure what the point of saying illusory wall behind the illusory wall is, but I'll upvote it anyway. Magic clutch ring. Probably useless to me, but let's check it out. Increases magic attack, but compromises damage absorption. That sounds like a speedrunner ring. Kind of like the red tear stone. Ring depicting a hand grasping a blue stone. Increases magic attack, but compromises damage absorption. An old fable in Londor claims that the lore of the clutch ring reaches out to the crestfallen, who might otherwise be overcome by despair. I almost read Londor as London. An old fable in London! That's Dark Souls lore, right? So, if I fall from up there, I can get that item. Okay. Before that, let's see what's down here. Other than the pyromancer. Let's actually fight the pyromancer first. Shit. Got their helmet. Let's see, much lighter. A bit worse. I guess the defense for weight ratio is probably pretty good, but weight isn't an issue, so nah. Let's see how it looks, though. Pretty cool. Kinda creepy. Pitch black inside the helmet. Is this the right helmet? Cathedral Knight? Yeah, everything's Fallen Knight except the helmet. Yeah, that's right. Had an existential crisis for a moment there. Ah, right, I've already been over there, nothing there. Okay, let's go get that item. Ring of the Sun's Firstborn. That sounds cool. Greatly boosts miracles. Well, never mind. Who inherited the light of Gwen, the First Lord. Greatly boosts miracles. The Sun's Firstborn was once a god of war, until he was stripped of his stature as punishment for his foolishness. No wonder his very name has slipped from the annals of history. Ah, so many magic rings. Makes me want to cry. Okay. Well, I think that's all explored up to the boss, but I don't want to tackle the boss just yet. I want to find what bonfire this links up with, because I really don't remember. There must be a bonfire back here by just a little bit. Because that's the shortcut, so the bonfire must be near the shortcut. Yeah, so there's two assholes over there. I think I've been up here. Oh, that links up with that! Okay, yeah, that is very close to the bonfire. Okay. Alright, so I'm just gonna put the boss on hold. I'm gonna tackle that later. And what I'm going to do is... let's see, before I go to the boss, there's a couple places to go. I need to continue down the other bonfire down there, the bonfire I found around the water down there. There's a place I could go down there. Looks like it's pretty extensive. And also, I don't think I've been up here either. Try above. Oh, it looks like you're meant to fall down here, not actually get up here. Yeah, okay, so that's nothing for now. In that case, as far as I can tell, there are two ways to go. Into the boss room and down the pathway where the other bonfire is. So I think I'm going to tackle that other pathway in the next episode. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.